those things are important for doing theology. But when you're doing apologetics, those sorts of things are not presupposed, lest one be arguing in a circle.
Aha! Aha! Lest one be arguing in a circle. And here's the problem with that. You see, there's this thing called ultimate authorities. And any ultimate authority, fundamentally, if you're going to accuse of something, is going to be circular, because an ultimate authority cannot appeal to an authority above and beyond itself. When you, and I learned this from someone else many, many, many years ago, we all learn everything from somebody else. When you go into the court of law, well, used to anyways, and you put your hand on a Bible, why do you used to do that? You are swearing by something greater than yourself. You're saying, I'm going to speak the truth, and I swear by one that has higher authority than me that I'm speaking the truth. You see, this is the nature of oaths in the scripture. You get swearing by the temple, so on and so forth. Well, that's something that's greater than I am, so that's why I swear by it. Who does God swear by? By himself, because there's nothing greater than him. Well, isn't that circular? Yes, because he has to be the ultimate authority. And that's why scripture's truthfulness is not derived from any authority outside of itself, and cannot be, because if there is an authority greater than God speaking, then that becomes the ultimate authority you're trying to prove. And so, if you have the highest view of scripture, that it's God speaking, it's not just simply men thinking about God, their words elevated by the Spirit of God, or something like that. If you believe the scripture is actually revelation, that it's Theopneustos, then you can point to its consistency to other things as indicators of its truthfulness, but those cannot become the basis upon which you accept its truthfulness.